This is B. Nagaraju, contract lecturer in botany from Government Degree College, Korotla. So my topic name is Evolution of the Sporophyte in Bryophytes. So this is my topic, Evolution of the Sporophyte in Bryophytes. So these are the my topic contents. So the introduction, theory of sterilization, and last one is the reduction theory. Now see the first introduction. The sporophyte of liverworts and mosses show mostly of the same fundamental plan. The sporophyte of liverworts and mosses show mostly the same fundamental plan. So it is made up of an anchoring and absorbing foot, a stalk like ceta, and a capsule which is contains spores and elaters. The following two contrasting views have been put forward with regard to the evolution of sporophyte in bryophytes. So the first one is the evolution of sporophyte by the progressive sterilization of potential sporogenous tissue. And second one is, this is the first type, this is the second one is the evolution of the sporophyte due to progressive reduction or simplification. So these are the contrasting views have been put forward with regard to the evolution of sporophytes in bryophytes. So now see the theory of sterilization. So in that we see the progressive tissues. So this is the theory, sterilization theory, theory of sterilization. So this view, according to this view, also known as the theory of progressive evolution or theory of sterilization. So this theory was put forward by the Bauer, who is the scientist name? Bauer, in 1908-35, and supported by the Cavertz and Campbell. So according to this theory, or according to this view, the sporophyte of complex forms, for example, Funaria, Sphagnum, and Pogonatum, have evolved due to progressive sterilization of potential fertile tissue of the simpler forms, from, for example, Rickettsia and Marchantia. So this according to theory, this view, sporophyte of complex to form have evolved due to progressive sterilization of the potential fertile tissue of the simpler form. So this, according to this theory, the evolution is complex to simple. So the first one is, we see the first one. So this is the Rickettsia. The simplest known sporophyte among the bryophyte is that Rickettsia. In all species of Rickettsia, the sporophyte consists only capsule. So this is the capsule, only capsule, there being no trace of ceta and foot. So Rickettsia doesn't possess any ceta or foot. So the oospore, so this is the only oospore. So the mother cells of the sporophyte divides the first by the a transfer and then by a vertical wall to form four-celled in embryo and which become 20 to 30 celled by the further division. And occasionally a few cells fail to develop into spores, and these sterile cells, it is called as nurse cells, have nutritive function and are supported to be the ancestor of elaters. So this is the ancestor of elaters. So this is the first stage in the sporophyte evolution. This is the simplest sporophyte is the Rickettsia. So next second one is the second stage is in Corasina. The sporophyte divides by transfer wall into hypobasal and epibasal cell. The former gives rise to a small foot, and the derivatives of the epibasal cell from an outer ampithecium and inner endothecium. So thus in the sporophyte Corasina, the sterilization has gone a step further, and is additional to nurse cell, a sterile foot is also present. So now see the Corasina, and this is the third stage is further sterilization is seen in sporocarpus, where the sporophyte has a sterile bulbous foot and a narrow ceta in addition to fertile the capsule. So this is the foot, and this is the ceta, and this is the capsule of sporocarpus. So the ampithecium, in the internal structure, the ampithecium forms a single layer, and jacket of the capsule and the endothecium and the sporogenous tissue and the sterile nurse cells. So these are the nurse cells, and this is the calyptra formed. So involucre is formed. So this is the simple to complex. Complexity is increasing in the evolution, sporophyte evolution. And this is the fourth stage. So Tarzania. This is the Tarzian sporophyte is differentiated into the bulbous foot. This is the bulbous foot, and it is a massive ceta. So this is the ceta and a capsule. So this is the capsule. So the ampithecium gives rise to a single layer, jacket layer of the capsule, and only about half of the endothecial cells gives rise to fertile sporogenous tissue, and then remaining half of the sterile jacket. And sterile scatters. And thus in the sporophyte of the Tarzania, there is a still further sterilization of sporogenous tissue is comparison to Rickettsia, Corasina and Spirocarpus. Now see the fifth stage of evolution of sporophyte. So this is the Marchantia sporophyte. In Marchantia, the lower half of the hypobasal cell of the contact embryo forms the foot and ceta, and upper half of epibasal is the capsule. So this is the foot, and this is the ceta, and this is the capsule. So this is the capsule. And approximate 50% of the sporogenous cells form spores, and the remaining 50% is for elaters with characteristic thickening bands are formed. So thus a bulbous foot, so this is the bulbous foot, and a single and an elongated ceta, this is the elongated ceta, a single layered capsule. So this is the single layered capsule, capsule wall, and a large number of elaters. So these are the thread like structures are called are elaters, and sterile constituents of the sporophyte of Marchantia. So this is the Marchantia sporophyte. And next to sixth stage. So in that sporophyte evolution, we see the sixth stage. So further sterilization of the sporophytic tissue can be seen in Pellia. So this is the Pellia sporophyte. So the sporophyte of Pellia is also differentiated into foot and seta and capsule. So this is the capsule. This is the capsule. The sporophyte of Pellia is also differentiated into foot, seta and capsule in Marchantia, but the jacket of the capsule is two or more layer. So this capsule is jacket is two more layer. So furthermore, a fixed sterile elater force is present at the proximal end of the capsule with a bunch of elaters. So these are the bunch of elaters are formed. So this is the sixth stage example of Pellia sporophyte. This is the Pellia. So next one we see the seventh stage. So this is the sporophyte of Anthoceras. So Anthoceras is a great interest from the point of view of evolution. The mature sporophyte consists of bulbous foot. So this is the bulbous foot and horn or bristle like capsule. So this is the bristle like capsule. So this is the bristle like capsule. And the elaters of Anthoceras known as pseudo elaters. So these are the pseudo elaters are formed in that Anthoceras, as they do not possess any thickening bands. And thus, from the point of view of sterility and self-dependency, the sporophyte of Anthoceras is more specialized than those of the hepatic Apsida. And the next one we see the eighth stage of the evolution process. So we see the good example of Bryopsida. So this is the capsule of Fineria. So this Fineria capsule, the region is like a foot. So this is the foot region. So this is the seta, and this is the foot. Foot, this inside of this is the foot region, the foot and seta and capsule. This is the entire, this part is called as capsule. So in that capsule wall and columella, these are called as columella, and apophysis, this is the apophysis, and this part is called as operculum, and so these stones are called peristomes. So in that bryophyta, and Fineria, polytrichum and pogonatum represent the sterile tissues. So what we understand, so thus the sporophyte of Rickettsia is the simplest amongst the bryophytes, and with very high proportion of the fertile tissue, and the sterile tissue is very small. So on the other hand, the members of the classes of Bryopsida, Funaria, Polytrichum, Pogonatum have the most complex sporophyte with very high degree of sterility. So the evolution of the sporophyte in bryophytes such as considered to have take place by the progressive sterilization of the fertile tissue. So now see the reduction theory, second theory this is the. So now we have seen the progressive theory, now see the reduction theory, this is the second theory. So there is a however an opposite school of thought led by the Kashyap and Church and Gobel and Evans. So they hold that correlated the evolution of the sporophyte has been in the downward direction. The series of the beliefs furnishes an example of retrogressive evolution, not progressive, it is a retrogressive evolution. So there is a ample evidence of reduction rather than progressive elaboration of the sporophyte of this group. So the significant steps in the reduction series are simplification of the dehiscence apertures and a reduction of the green photosynthetic tissue in the capsule wall associated with the above is the disappearance of stomata and intercellular spaces. So these are the significant steps in the reduction series. And now see the one more points. And side by side with the above changes in the gradually elimination of the ceta and subsequently the disappearance of the foot, and all these changes are accompanied by the progressive increasing in the fertility of the progressive cells, and evidences from comparative morphology and experimentally genetics supports the view that the simple sporophyte of Rickettsia is an advanced but reduced structure. Thank you for watching this video.